Now this time, let's try to parametrize a plane, because just like the simplest curve would be a line, and trying to parametrize a line was the simplest thing to do. I guess the simplest thing that you can parametrize is a plane. So think about the following case. You have this 1, 1, 1. So here's x, here's y, here's z. You have 1, 1, 1. And let's say you have a plane cutting through these points. Okay, so, for example, these are now, this portion is like behind the sheet. So it's in this, behind the semi-transparent sheet, so it's hard to see, but now this is coming out. Okay. Now, what I want to do is to actually parametrize the portion of the plane that is this much. Okay. So this sheet is actually infinite, but I just want to parametrize the portion of the sheet that's this much. Okay. Now, just like when you had parametrization of regular curves, especially in 2D for lines, it was convenient to just start with the line equation and then introduce the t as x equals to t, then automatically, so for example, if you had like y equals to 2x and you wanted to parametrize this, how did you do it? You just said x equals to t and then you plug that in and you get y equals to 2t, and that gave you a parametrization, right? Same idea here. What I want to do is I want to come up with the equation of the line, equation of the plane, and then set x as u and y as v, and then z would be represented in terms of u and v just because of the equation given. Okay. So our first goal would be to actually come up with the equation for this plane. Now, what's the equation of the plane? Can you tell me the formula for the equation of the plane? What's the equation of the plane? A x minus x naught, B y minus y naught, C z minus z naught equal to 0. Now for x naught comma y naught comma z naught, I can choose any point. So if I chose this point, which is 1 comma 0 comma 0, I can choose, I'll have that as our value. Okay. Then we need to know a comma b comma c. What's the meaning of a comma b comma c? It's a normal vector. Normal vector is the plane. This normal vector is the plane. Now, because this is kind of symmetric, you probably know what the normal vector is. Can you guess what the normal vector is? 1, 1, 1, right? Yeah. The vector that's 1, 1, 1 will be coming from the origin, going straight through the center of this triangle, so that it's perpendicular to this plane, right? Now, if it wasn't 1, 1, 1, if it was like 1, 2, 3, then you have to do some more calculations. It's not that straightforward. It's not intuitive. So you would find this vector by doing terminal minus initial. You get the other vector. You have to do a cross product to find the actual normal vector, right? So that's how we learned to do it early on in the course. And I'm going to assume that we know, but I chose to do this simple one so that we don't have to go through all that. Okay, so just by intuition, I know that it's 1, 1, 1. So what's the equation of the plane that we have? This is 1 times x minus 1 plus 1 times y minus 0 plus 1 times z minus 0 equal to 0. So this is x minus 1 plus y plus z equal to 0. And if you solve this for z, you get z equal to 1 minus x minus y, right? All the signs will be negative because you're moving to the other side, so x becomes negative x, negative 1 becomes positive 1, y becomes negative y. So that's what we have. And given that this is the equation of the plane, now we can parametrize it as the following. We can say if x is u and y is v, then z would be what? Can you tell me what I should write?
1 minus u minus v.
Yeah, because see, z is 1 minus x minus y, but I said x is u, y is v, so z would be 1 minus u minus v, so that you can write this as r uv equal to u comma v comma 1 minus u minus v, like that, okay? That's what. However, that's not going to give us just this portion of the plane. Why? Huh? It'll be the whole plane. Why? Because u and v are not limited to anything, right? U and v are anything, so it's going to give me the whole plane. So in order to just get this portion of the plane, we need to limit the values of u and v. Now, remember that I've let x as u and y as v, so really what we're looking at is, if you want to know what are the possible values of u and v, you need to know where u and v travels along the xy plane. So think about this tetrahedron obtained by the xy, yz, and xz plane, and this triangle. You can think about that tetrahedron, right? Think about the base of the tetrahedron. That base actually gives you the bounds for x and y, which is in turn u and v, because we let x equal to u and y as v, so that gives you the bounds for those, okay? So let's just try to draw that what that is on the xy plane. Here's x, y. Now, I know that it passes through 1, 0, 0, so over here it's 1, 0, okay? And there's another point marked at 1 on the y-axis, so here's 1, okay? And that plane's gonna cut, and it's gonna give me that line, and then we're gonna get this triangle. Right. So now I have to somehow come up with the bounds for this, but that's exactly what we've been doing when we were doing double integrals, right? So if you can remember how we did the double integrals, then we can easily write down the bounds, okay? So suppose you were to draw, write an integral f x y dy dx, what would you write here and there? So we first need the equation for this, right? What's the equation for this? The slope is?
Negative 1.
Y-intercept is 1, so y is equal to?
Negative x plus 1,
right? So that's this line, okay? So if I had dy, what did I put here? 0 to negative x plus 1, right? And then x is 0 to 1, just like that, right? Okay, so now we can say the following. X is between 0 to 1, and y is between 0 to negative x plus 1. Okay. And then you still have to change this into u and v, because this is u and v, so now I can take this and put it over here to finalize my answer. What is the value for u? Between?
0 and 1.
0 and 1. And for v? 0 to?
Minus x plus 1.
Minus u plus 1. Okay. So that is the parametrization of this triangle.